My name's Peter Rad. I'm a photographer here in New York, and I primarily do advertising and magazine work. And I kind of mix that with my fine artwork, which I also show in galleries. We had the Odeon restaurant in Tribeca for 6 hours. You can imagine it's a pretty famous, kind of busy restaurant, so they wouldn't give us much more, and we had to pretty much set up everything. We had a cast of about 40. So it was very hectic. I mean, all told, I think there were about 60 people on the set, and we had limited time, so it was a scramble. But it started kind of nice and quiet. We met there early with the main characters, and we had breakfast with them. And well, she was just sort of a dynamo, you know. She came in and she had an amazing presence.
Heck yeah, I'm ready for whatever.
Okay.
It was interesting because it was such a big campaign, we cast more people than we normally would, and then we shot with I think about 3 or 4 possibilities as main characters. And then once we had the images, we edited the images and chose the main character from there. So basically, at the point at which we were shooting, we didn't know that Lyric was going to be the main character, but the images that we produced with her tended to be the more, I guess they stood out from the rest, you know, in terms of her, just her glow and her presence.
Really?
There was just something very graceful about her and how she took what was a fairly sort of mundane acting role, if you will. I mean, there was not much in it for her being a good actress, particularly, you know, the fact that we're ending up with a still, there's not much to work with. But she worked way beyond that and took it on board as a sort of a time-based performance and really went with it. And so I do remember when we were shooting it, I thought to myself, wow, she seems to be gliding along the floor, and that's just really beautiful. And I think that kind of lightness, if you will, really resonates in the image. Ironically, I didn't have to direct her as much as I had to direct the people around her, which was great because she totally got it, and she, she took the sort of the short projected narrative that I gave her, the little vignette, you know, and we even played around with some lines. And so she, you know, had her lines, and then she just went with that, you know, and sort of went around the tables and just moved so beautifully, you know. So that was really good because it was less about directing her. She kind of did that for me, and there was a nice trust there. I was walking down 6th Avenue with some friends, and it was a Sunday, and it was fairly quiet down that end of 6th Avenue, and I just remember looking up to the right, and I wasn't expecting the billboards to be up yet, and just remember seeing this image and feeling really proud, of course, for myself too, because it was my first big billboard campaign in New York. So, but the image of Lyric just had this incredible presence where she was just floating out of the image, and it was just a beautiful kind of ethereal thing that just gave the whole experience for me, which was, you know, as I said, a personal kind of personally gratifying. It just kind of added to that it actually projected that well. I lost a brother when I was 17, who was 20 years old, in tragic circumstances also, and like Lyric, he was, I guess, had a special presence, so I think there was just an instant connection to that experience, and I just remember thinking, I just remember looking, thinking back to the image, and just because the image had sort of really kind of grown just in her presence in the image. And so I just immediately thought of that. It was devastating, and it was confusing, because here's a girl who I don't even really know, and yet clearly my experience with her, my limited experience with her, moved me. And then of course there's the intensity of what actually happened, and that it's something I'll never stop thinking about. I mean, I always think about it, and always it's pretty close to me. I can't get away from that. It's clear that even while she was here, I mean, she had this incredible presence. There was no doubt about that. And just reading, you know, some of the stories about her since then, it's amazing to map out her life and to kind of reflect on that in terms of how she still is affecting people now.
It's stranger sitting at your table with a camera and a microphone.
Well, yeah, and you know, and when you emailed me, I was actually really happy that it continues, because there's so much good stuff that she had to offer, and it continues to project.